The following is a production of Fenix Media. The views expressed do not necessarily represent those of the company or its advertisers and may contain language that's unsuitable for younger listeners.
You know, out in Nevada near the silver mines, there's a kind-hearted woman. She's looking so fine, always taking care of her community. Bringing folks together is her cup of tea. She's out on the road and all over the web with a big smiling heart. It's About Town Deb.
And welcome to this week's episode of City Talk with About Town Deb. And as you can see, I'm on location at Mari Chuy's in Midtown. He does have a location also in Sparks, Nevada, and a brand new one opening up at the Village in South Reno. So I'm grateful to be here at Mari Chuy's in Midtown in Reno, Nevada. And before I thank my sponsors, I want to introduce to you my guests that we'll be hearing about more in the next segment. So I'm going to start with Kevin O'Keefe. And we have Briana Dolan. We have, we have a daughter and son who are new to town, who are rocking our community, Reno Fine Arts Collective. And we're going to tell you all about it. I'm so happy they're here. So that's what you're going to hear about. And you're going to hear about some cool events coming up. But without my amazing engineer with PhoenixMedia.us, Christian, we wouldn't even be doing this. So thank you, Christian, for being the man behind the screen. And without our amazing sponsors, Kim Surratt of Surratt Law Practice and Kirk Allure with Gratis Gives Processing, credit card processing. So when you use Kirk Allure's credit card processing, you get a discounted rate and a portion goes to a local charity. So you don't even have to do anything. Every time that's swiped, you're going to a local charity. So I'm so grateful to have amazing sponsors. And last week, I also wanted to say we got some cool things coming up, partnerships. So excited. I'm more over the moon excited to say that we have Dorinda's Chocolate officially starting May on board as a sponsor. We have Dolce Vita Spa is going to have my wine, About Town Deb, on the menu at their new spa at the Village. So that's pretty darn cool. Noble Pie at the Summit location. We're going to be having a wings and wine event. So I'm excited for that. I love that partnership. We also are partnered with Wild River Grill, officially starting May. They're also going to be a sponsor. And guess what? Hall and Rye Plastic Surgeons are going to be working on this. So you might see me sometimes, and I'm all full of whatever I'm full of or skin peeling. It's going to be amazing. I cannot wait to see the results. So it's beauty from the inside out. I'm so excited to have all their support. So with all of that said, those are the new updates. And we are actually, as you know, we changed our show to be live on Wednesdays at 5 p.m. on YouTube, Facebook Live. If you're watching right now, it is a Tuesday. We're going to film on Tuesdays. So it is Tuesday at Mari Chuy's. And every Tuesday for the month of April, we are having a tequila tasting. So let's see if I can get the name right. It is Faganero. What? Brianna, did I get that right? Brianna, yeah, that's right. Good. Faganero. I'm trying to get the accent going. So we're really excited because on Tuesdays from 4 to 6, you can get a sample for free, and then you can taste it, taste other ones, and get special deals for a raffle. So we are going to be enjoying that tonight, and tonight we're having an amazing dinner, which we'll share next week with you. So let's just get right down to business. Reno is all about art. You know that, right? If you guys are visiting Reno, we have murals, we have amazing artists, all really cool. Well, these two guys right here contacted About Town Deb a while ago, and we had an amazing meeting, and their story and what they want to bring to our community is beyond anything we could imagine. We are going to our art is already rocking it, but we're going to take it up notches with all of our local artists and with their help. So we want to start with which founder wants to go first, dad or daughter?
I go first.
Kevin is going to go first. So Kevin, tell us I'm just going to go a little personal side. What is it like working with your daughter, and how did you two get here to do this amazing project?
Working with Bri is really great. She's a great creative, and she also has a background in marketing and communication. So she's actually doing most of the heavy lifting on this.
She's lifting.
This is very true.
anyway, so how we came out here, so Briana married one of the Dolans. Mm-hmm. And so she was coming out and she was visiting. We would come out and visit with her. And so we became familiar with the Reno area. And so she was able to move out first in June. And then we were able to follow later in October. And so we're just absolutely delighted to be here. Love the area. But the big news is when we came, we're both artists. I'm an oil painter. And Bree does very involved paper collages. And we came out.
Wait, hold on. She does what kind of paper collages?
Very involved paper collages.
Very involved. Okay. Does that have another name? They're just very involved.
They're very.
You like a collage, like little pieces together?
Very tiny
like,
pieces.
Like a puzzle. Like
tremendous yes. detail.
Okay.
I can do a beautiful oil painting in 2 or 3 days. It takes her weeks to get one of these things done. And they're absolutely beautiful.
So. I need to see that soon. We got to share that. Okay.
I will send you one.
Anyway, so when we came out here, you know, because of the COVID and so we had a lot of time on our hands. And so we said, well, we have all this art. Why don't we just go up and put something online and see if we can sell some of it to entertain ourselves. And so we did that.
They're very entertaining, by the way.
And what was amazing is we did a little bit of research for Reno and was stunned to see that there were literally hundreds of very qualified, very talented artists right here in this town. We had no idea. And I came from a background of design and art. All around other communities and cities around the world. And I was so surprised to see that. And so the thinking was, why couldn't we just take, rather than just be the two of us, why don't we combine all of what is best about Reno's artists and put it all in one place? Reno Fine Arts Collective was born, and it just took off like a shot. I mean, right away, as soon as we put it out there, we had artists coming on, and now we have over 25 artists with 20 waiting to come on. It's just been this tremendous... It's been like it's really an expedition that's taken on a life of its own, and we couldn't be happier about the results of it.
Whew! But with all that said, it's almost time for a break. And what is so special about both of these amazing human beings is that they have our drive of Reno being together with one heart, and they're about building us up and building bridges and having the art world rock and shine with our own local artists. And I'm so happy about that. So stay tuned. We're going to go for a quick break. It is About Town Dev with City Talk. And we're going to come back and talk all about art, all about our amazing community. So stay tuned. About Town Dev with City Talk.
Now more than ever, family matters. And Surratt Law Practice has your family in mind. Kimberly Surratt and her team have been helping maintain healthy families through their holistic approach to adoption and surrogacy, child custody, estate planning, and more for over 13 years. Your family law concerns are in caring hands with Surratt Law. Schedule your private consultation with a compassionate Surratt Law Practice team member today by calling 775-636-8200 or visiting lawyersforfamilies.com. Surratt Law, where family matters.
That'll be $73.11.
Do you have a charity that I can donate a buck to?
You just did.
But I didn't select any option.
It happened just by using your credit card. We recently changed our payment processing to Gratis Gives, who not only saves our company a ton of money on processing fees, but also donates a portion of every purchase to a participating local nonprofit.
Why doesn't every business do that?
If they switch to Gratis Gives like we did, they can.
Achieve real social change by contacting Gratis Gives at 855-464-7284 or online at gratisgives.com.
I spend a lot of time in the backyard, and I'm the center of attention at summer barbecues. In 96, I made some of the tastiest s'mores. And in 09, it was me, your backyard fire pit, that accidentally started a wildfire when a summer breeze carried one of my embers into some dry brush.
Spark a change, not a wildfire. Visit SmokeyBear.com, brought to you by the U.S. Forest Service, your state forester, and the Ad Council.
Only you. Can prevent wildfires.
Hope you enjoyed your meal. And I just want to say, he's lucky to have a brother like you.
Lucky? Caring for my brother is far from easy. But he's a part of me, like my arms and legs, so I'll be his. No time for tired. Nothing can disable this love. He needs me, but I'm the lucky one, even though I need help now and then.
If you're caring for a loved one, visit aarp.org/caregiving for care guides and community. Support for your strength. Brought to you by AARP and the Ad Council.
What if I told you that a tornado was going to happen tomorrow, right where you live? That it would touch down at exactly 3:17 p.m. and I told you the exact path it would take. You would, of course, prepare. You would talk with your loved ones, and you'd make a plan today. It's true. I can't tell you a tornado will strike tomorrow. but shouldn't you have a plan anyway? Go to ready.gov/communicate and make your emergency plan today. Don't wait. Communicate. Brought to you by FEMA and the Ad Council.
This is Mario Andretti. You know me as a race car driver, but I'm also a Meals on Wheels volunteer. I've raced against the sport's biggest personalities, but I've never met more vibrant, amazing people than the seniors served by Meals on Wheels. You can make a difference by dropping off a hot meal and saying a quick hello. So, America, let's do lunch. Volunteer your lunch break at americaletsdolunch.org.
This message brought to you by Meals on Wheels America and the Ad Council.
You're listening to Fenix Media. Listen live and explore more great shows at phoenixmedia.us.
She's out on the road and all over the web with a big smiling heart. It's About Town Deb.
My town, your town, or any town, this is About Town Deb presents City Talk. Now back to the show.
Welcome back to the second segment of City Talk. I'm About Town Deb, a.k.a. Debbie McCarthy, your host. I am so excited to be at Midtown Reno, Nevada at Mari Chuy's, one of my favorite local hotspots. And I got to say, I've known Maria and Chuy for over 20 years. So it's so cool. The partnerships which you build in our community are everlasting. And these guys here have already rocked the partnerships. And we're going to share a little bit about the partnerships that they have created already with the art and where they're going next. But before, I think fair play, we got to be fair here. So, Briana, what is it like to work with Dad? And then tell us what the next step is.
Okay. It's been surprisingly great.
Not only surprisingly. Did you hear that?
Only surprisingly, because I've spent a lot of my life with this man. So now moving into a business partnership has been an easy segue. And I love it because he comes to pick me up for all of our meetings.
Oh, so
it's
like
a real chauffeur situation. And it's true that I do the heavy lifting, so I will take credit for that. But he has the business background, and he has a really strong vision for our future with this collective. So I'm just super excited to be on board with him about that. So, and then I guess our next step, we have the online gallery, which is exploded since we launched this thing in February. We have, like my dad said, 25 artists and 20 more coming. We have over 200 pieces of art available for sale on the site, between all the artists that are part of membership. And our next step, until we actually have a physical gallery, which is our next step, we've created something we're calling a counter gallery, which is really about digging our heels into the Reno community and partnering with all these great local establishments and getting the art of the collective up on display for sale in all these places. And there's art everywhere around town already, but we just kind of wanted to expand that on a much larger scale. And we've had so much fun doing it because everyone we meet is so great and they're so supportive of the arts here. And so right now, I mean, maybe Debbie, you can tell
everyone. Well, what I'm excited about is some of the places that they were in right away, because, you know, I'm all about collaborating and partnering. I love that Home Meets Nevada. I have been a biggest fan of them since they first opened.
They're the best.
And then 10 Tour. Oh my gosh. I was like, the first time I met them, we were at 10 Tour, and 10 Tour is creating an About Town Deb drink that will be in November because the whiskey has to be redone. They ran out of that one. So, and Annalisa is one of my good friends. So how cool is it that when I meet them for the first time, I'm with Annalisa and I'm at 10 Tour. It's amazing. And then Pantry Products. Who doesn't like amazing products from our local Reno? Big Horn Olive Oil Company. Oh my gosh. That was one of the first businesses that I connected with. And my dad, as you know, Papa Tony, loved going in there. So I know that that's a big one for me. And now I haven't done a lot with Reno Running Company, which I need to, because I need to start walking before I run. But I do know they were saying up next is the coffee bar and the Nest. Those two are amazing places as well that I actually go to and love. So you're picking amazing partners that I truly love. And actually, Tina Makawa, so Tina is one of my long, I have a hard time with names. It's Debbie talk. But she actually messaged me and said, oh my gosh, guess what? I just got accepted. I love it when local artists are reaching out to me saying, how cool is this? So the idea that you're bringing on our very own talent means the world to all of us in our community.
Well, it's amazing. I mean, the diversity, if you go onto the website, just I mean, it's just their website right now. But if you go on and just see the amount of just different kinds of art and different talent and how amazing it is. I mean, really, it's so cool. Just like I go on all the time to edit it, but I love to see just the images of the work that our artists are doing because it's unreal and it's all here.
So it's not, I could have this wrong, but I've been looking at the Facebook page and different things. Is it not just art as an art? Is there jewelry? Is there other stuff?
Yes.
So share about that, because when you say art, sometimes you just think a portrait.
Right,
it's
exactly.
Not just that. So share about what other kind of arts that people are saying, right. Hey, I want to be a part of it.
So we've been, as we describe it, we say it's the creative talent. So it's arts and luxury artisan goods. We want to include bespoke furniture. So when eventually when we have our
wait, say that again?
Bespoke furniture.
What is that?
It's like fancy handmade furniture.
So that's art. It is art.
Yeah, and like lighting pieces.
Oh, I love
that. And there's so many jewelers around Reno, which I didn't know about. Again, all of this has been a learning experience for us, but each phase of it has been another great surprise because if you just go around Midtown, there's plenty of artisan jewelers just here.
And that's where we are right now, in Reno, Nevada, Midtown. But there's also a lot of artists who are doing amazing pieces for our local businesses. Like Dulce Vita Spa is opening up in the Village. I know they have a lot of local artists who have made furniture pieces.
Right.
And I know that there's a lot of local artists that are doing big, beautiful furniture pieces.
Well, it's incredible because we also have a lot of glass makers around Reno, too. And for example, Peter Hazel, who was our first artist.
I love Peter. He's great.
We are so happy to have him. But we went and saw his studio space. And I don't know if you've seen his jellyfish.
Oh, my gosh, yes.
So that's what we're kind of talking about with this whole bespoke lighting and furniture. That we envision hanging those jellyfish lights everywhere when we have a gallery space and eventually for our show, which I'm sure my dad will talk about.
Yeah, we'll talk about that.
Yes.
So when you vision this, now that you've shared a little bit more, now I kind of get it. I was thinking it was just art, but to walk into when you have this exhibit and you see furniture and hanging, you know, the lights and the art and the sculptures and the jewelry, yeah. It really is like walking into another world.
Right. And it's all made. It's like it is art. All of it is art.
It's all art.
Yes. And the jewelry has been especially fun because there's so many interesting styles, but they all have this very specific Nevada feel, I feel like. It's, you got that kind of, I mean, now that we're, you know, locals.
They're locals now.
I feel like I can really pick up on that, and it's just been really fun to see that. And, you know,
what's most amazing, though, is that the concentration of art and talent here in this place is so tremendous. I mean, I run events in Paris.
I want to hear about that. So, Paris, London.
Never would people, speaking people in Europe, in Paris or in New York, ever think that, you know, Reno was such a center of art and culture. And we really want to be able to celebrate that. And the website is the first step in that. And now we're doing this counter gallery. But then the next thing we're going to do is have a physical gallery and make it very easy for all artists to come in. It will cost them nothing to come in position. Any art that's actually sold will be commercially less than half of what a gallery would charge.
Wow.
So, and we're going to promote it. Not just here, we're going to promote it all over the United States. So the space we're looking at now is about 12,000 feet across from City Hall, easily fit 50 artists in that, and it'll be a very elegant art gallery. So it's going to look like Stremel. You're going to walk through and you're going to see beautiful lighting and all of what's best from Reno Tower will be in there. And we want to be able to use that to ground a new art district for downtown. So.
And to have it be a fun place to go and have it be just an open house, you know, constant hospitalities. We want to have the wine flowing.
Yeah. The wine flowing, just so you know.
That's right. That's going to help us
with that. I'll help with the wine. So if you are out there, we want local wine, El Dorado County wine. We want to really promote all of the localness that we have around. So local also means over the hill in El Dorado and Amador as well. But I want to go back to a little bit. So when you coming from, so what state did you come from?
From Connecticut.
So what is it like coming from Connecticut to Reno, and how do you feel about how, because I know you guys said you were welcome. So what's it like being here?
Well, it's the people are so friendly and so open and so giving. I mean, I work most of the time in New York City, which is like the opposite of what I just said. So it's just a very beautiful place geographically. And what's very unique about Reno is that people in Reno, and I've been involved in running events in cities all over the world. Never I've been in a place where everyone in the city and the retailers and the people here and the government all love where they are.
I know.
I mean, everybody, every place else, everyone's going someplace. We're here until I go someplace else. But everyone here wants this to
stay
be,
here.
Yes.
They want it to this to grow, and they want, and especially all the changes that we're seeing around the world, all around the country now, the population changes. I think that the destiny for Reno was to become a significant art and culture center.
Oh, I love it. So let's go back. I want to go back a little bit to where you were talking about the trade shows. And so a little bit about your background with that, because you're bringing that to us.
Right.
So before we like kind of finish up a little bit about that.
So I spent the last 30 years in the trade show business, initially as a designer for Ralph Lauren, Van Cleef & Arpels, and all of the top designers here in the country. And then moved from that into actually developing trade shows. So I took a company on the West Coast. We started with two shows. Ended up with 48 trade shows in 10 countries, sold up hundreds of millions of dollars, and after that went from, this is in California, went from California to New York, where I was tasked with developing the top design event for North America, which is ICFF. And then around that, I built New York City by Design, which is it was something that involved 400,000 people in all these events in all the boroughs, and the design and the art world. So that's what I did over the last 6 years. And so I know everything about the exhibition.
Are you kind of bored here?
No,
are you bored?
No.
That's a lot of work. I mean,
but he's had a break.
I know. I love the
COVID thing shut down all that down. So it took a long
time. I know, but I love the idea that we have such talent and heart that is in our not coming. You are here, and you're here to stay. So because they're here to stay, we're not going anywhere. We'll be back for our next after our next break. It's About Town Deva City Talk. Stay tuned. If you're watching the replay, if you're an artist, if you, no matter what kind of artist you are, jewelry, furniture, sculpting, oil, whatever, finger painting, I don't know, paint by the lines like me, we want to hear from you because you're amazing and we want you to be a part of this amazing collection. So it's About Time Deb. Stay tuned. Be right back.
Welcome to Calvin's Barbershop.
You all got to see this.
I don't even want to know what you're looking at on that phone.
Well, you should. I was learning about the dangers of high blood pressure and that we need to get ours checked regularly. High blood pressure can increase the risk of heart attack or stroke, but this text program can help keep it at a healthy range. Just text Barbershop to 97779 to sign up.
I'll get right on it as soon as I'm done with this baby panda video.
Text Barbershop to 97779. A message from the American Heart Association and the Ad Council.
That'll be $73.11.
Do you have a charity that I can donate up to?
You just did.
But I didn't select any option.
It happened just by using your credit card. We recently changed our payment processing to Gratis Gives, who not only saves our company a ton of money on processing fees, but also donates a portion of every purchase to a participating local nonprofit.
Why doesn't every business do that?
If they switch to Gratis Gives like we did, they can.
Achieve real social change by contacting Gratis Gives at 855-464-7284 or online at gratisgives.com.
Keyboard Cat, Hamilton the Pug, and Toast Meets World. These are some of the internet's most beloved pets. And they all have one thing in common. Their stories started in a shelter. Start your story. Adopt a dog or cat today. Visit theshelterpetproject.org to find a pet near you. Training that pet to play the keyboard, that's optional. Start a story. Adopt a shelter or rescue pet today. Brought to you by Maddie's Fund, the Humane Society of the United States, and the Ad Council.
Okay, what are you wearing right now?
Nothing.
That's right. So mommy's going to teach you how to dress yourself. Underwear always comes first, name tag at the back, then pants, then shirt. Get the first button in the right hole or you have to start all over. Socks go in first, then shoes, right on right, left on left. With shoelaces, just take the ends, cross them over, switch the loops, the rabbit goes down the hole, pull tight, and you're left with bunny ears. Got it? Why are your pants on your head?
Most parenting is hard to do in just 2 minutes. But 2 minutes twice a day, making sure they brush their teeth, is easier, and it could help save them from a lifetime of tooth pain. Visit 2min2x.org to find out more. A message from the Partnership for Healthy Mouths, Healthy Lives, and the Ag Council.
How's it going?
I'm having a stroke.
Are you going to shake my hand?
I'm having a stroke.
Wow, you're not even moving your arm.
I'm having a stroke.
When someone is having a stroke, they may not be able to say it with words, but their body language will tell you loud and clear. Look for FAST. F, face drooping. A, arm weakness. S, speech difficulty. T, time to call 911 immediately. Know the sudden signs. Spot a stroke fast. Visit strokeassociation.org. Brought to you by the American Stroke Association and the Ad Council.
The storks are bringing me a baby brother! We can do this together!
All right, let's go!
Storks know how to keep kids safe. Do you?
What?
Oh my gosh, you don't know!
I know!
You don't! Oh man, you laugh when you're uncomfortable.
No!
Making sure your child is in the right car seat is one of the steps to safer travel.
I will rock this!
You will rock this!
To know for sure that your child is in the right car seat for their age and size, visit safercar.gov/the right seat.
Cool, cool, cool. Very cool, very cool.
Brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration and the Ad Council.
You're listening to Fenix Media. Listen live and explore more great shows at phoenixmedia.us.
You know that's what she said. Come on, let's have some fun with About Town Deb.
My town, your town, or any town, this is About Town Deb presents City Talk. Now, back to the show.
And welcome back to the third segment of City Talk. And I'm About Town Deb, Debbie McCarthy, your host. I am so excited to have Kevin and Brianna here with me. And I'm telling you, they are rocking the Reno creative movement. All about art, all about family, all about heart and art, because we are together with one heart. And during break, I forgot something really important. Brianna said, who did your song? DDJames.com. He's one of my amazing friends. He's a producer, a music writer, and I'm thinking I might try to get him playing some music in the Reno area. So yeah, if you're interested, DDJames.com. And I always give a shout out to Grandma Bean at Glenda. Can't forget that. So I love you guys, and I thank you for all you do in my life. So that's kind of like the Carol Burnett thing. She does this. I just say it. So Grandma Bean at Glenda, I love you. So we were talking about, you know, all this amazing stuff and where you've come from and where we're going and where we're at. But there's a lot more that you actually have nailed down to show you that they just didn't come here and have an idea. They planted roots, and we have a plan. They have a plan. So, Brianna, share a little bit about the actual plan and what's happening.
So our greatest goal, the end goal, is to change the way that Reno Tahoe is viewed from the outside. As an arts destination, a center for creative talent, a city that people recognize as a source for this kind of collective. And so by the few things we've talked about so far will lead into that, but the biggest effort that will get the most attention will be the Reno's first international art show.
Yay!
So we're eyeing the second weekend of September, which is the same weekend as the Great Reno Balloon Races. And we have met with the convention center, and we actually booked the space. So we're good. We are on our way, and we're super excited about it because it's a gorgeous layout, and it's going to be perfect for what we have envisioned, outdoor and indoor space. And we have a lot of planning to do, of course. But
I want to throw something in. Did you hear say international? That is huge, okay? We're talking about bringing international artists and people and buyers to our community, which also means hotel rooms. It means all of that. It's you're bringing people to our town, and especially after the pandemic, we want to showcase our talent here. So you're giving us a gift of bringing people here to showcase our people and them. So,
well, I think it's a gift to the international art community as well, because with the pandemic, so much has changed, of course, but people in general, I don't think, are looking forward to going back to events that are in the big cities like LA, San Francisco, and New York. People are looking for a change, a new destination, and a place that maybe is not as concerning as those major cities. So Reno offers that, and it's so easy to get around here. 10 minutes to literally get anywhere in the city.
Yeah.
And so that allows us to do what my dad was talking about with this citywide, which he did in New York. But we can incorporate so many of our partners in all the local establishments and make it just this really amazing weekend that's already a draw for everyone with the balloon races. So,
and who doesn't love the balloon races? And I think the balloon races remind me of art as well, because each balloon has a theme, and the kids look up and they're so excited. Mm-hmm. So with the balloon races, I'm just going to ask Melissa's over here. What's the time frame from when you start and you end on the day? Come on, Melissa, just chime in.
So our first event every day is Dog Patrol, and that takes flight at about 5:30 in the morning. And then essentially the event goes until about 11 a.m., I'd say. That's with, like, food vendors, people shopping on Balloon Boulevard.
I love the Balloon Boulevard.
So the why I brought that up is because after that, the guests who are here visiting, let's show off our art and our talent. Mm-hmm. So I love the partnership again, and I love how organically our community supports each other. And you can have a meeting with one person, another person, all of a sudden, everybody's in and everybody's making a difference. And that's what happened with our meeting.
Yeah.
So I'm very, very, very grateful for all of that. So I want to go back a little bit about I'm going to get even more personal now.
Oh boy.
So being a Dolan, as if you live in Northern Nevada, you all know the Dolans. How did you get here? Because I know you have a little bit of a story. We heard Dad's story. So as much as you want to share, you don't have to go too personal.
Well, I met Mike when we were in college. So we did a program called Semester at Sea, which was really cool. It's like a floating ship, basically, which is, well, it's a ship, but it's a floating university.
So I did not know that.
You take all your classes on the ship and then you go around the world. So we had this experience together. We were great friends for many years, and we were only friends for many years, and then it changed after that. And and I met his family. Actually, my first trip to Reno, he drove me from San Diego to Reno, and I had never done a long trip like that. And my first impression is like, this better be worth it, because this is a 10-hour trip.
Oh God,
through the desert. But I got here and I was shocked because I thought it was such a beautiful city. I love the Dolan family.
They're great.
And that sealed the deal. So it was a few years after that we got married in Connecticut, but we always knew we were going to come back to Reno because all of Mike's family is here, and my family had visited a few times and loved it. So I knew it was an easy sell, which is true. And so once we came here last year, it was just like 3 months later that they joined us, and no one's looking back. I mean, my sisters are here from New York.
Oh,
I love it.
Oh my God. Yeah. They already moved here?
Yeah.
Okay. This is okay. They're planted here. Okay. We got a little one on the way, and you also have another one at home.
Two
at home. So they're not going anywhere.
Yeah, we're here to stay.
They're here to stay. And that's usually what happens with our community. We love the whole Northern Nevada, Reno, Tahoe, Carson area. And Sparks. We love our Sparks. We're not done, so don't go away. But give us the website, because oh, and you also have a logo contest.
Oh, yes.
So let's talk about that. Website and then logo contest.
Okay, the website is www.renofineartscollective.com.
Okay, one more time, slower.
www.renofineartscollective.com.
Perfect.
Check it out. It is created by me. It will probably have to be reconstructed in the future because it's very amateurish. It's good
for
what I expected. But no, check it out and check out the artists that are on it because they're really incredible. And we are working on recreating the logo because that was also by me. It also needs to be reworked.
Their logo is amazing, but I love the idea that they're doing a contest.
Yeah,
so tell us about that.
The contest is
the
running through June, now through June, and we're opening it to all locals, like designers, artists, anyone who wants to take a stab at it. We're looking for a logo to replace our Reno Fine Arts Collective logo, and then to create a new logo for the Reno Creative Movement, which is our big vision that's covering the whole umbrella concept of changing the way the Reno Tahoe is viewed. So those two logos are really going to carry us through the launch of the show, the launch of the physical gallery downtown once we get that going. And we're counting on the locals to create something really interesting.
They will.
To do that, because we want to plaster it on the building. We want to put it on all the marketing stuff. And of course, there's a $1,000 prize, which is not too bad. And exhibition space at the show. So anyone who even wants to give it a try, please, because we want to see what all the ideas are.
So I have a question for both of you. So where do you see the whole art collective? Where is your dream in 5 years? 5 years. What is your goal, and how do you vision in 5 years? Where do you want to be with this?
I'd like to be able to see a full facility event running at the convention center. So that'd be 300,000 square feet and 2,500 exhibiting companies from all over the world. We'll start with this pillar. We begin in September 22, which is going to be 80 or 90 galleries from all over the United States and Europe, plus real feature of all of the locals. The space that they gave us at the convention center is ideal. It's right at the entrance. We're going to have all of Burning Man stuff outside that Maria can bring over. Sculptures on the way in. A one continuous party. We're promoting it across the entire country. Oh. All the major magazines are in. Interior Design Magazine, El Decor, Lux Magazine. Hundreds of thousands of people.
We're just going
to... Yes. Anyway, so...
Can I hang out with you? I think we're hanging out together.
It's going to be great.
We start there. It'll be a big party. Deb's going to bring all the wine.
Yes.
So we're going to have interior designers and decorators coming from all over the country. You'll love it. Don't miss that. And the gallery downtown is going to be great. So take a look at that.
You're going to co-host all the time. Okay, Brianna, what is your dream, but not just as a business, as a mom and a family here? A little bit of both.
I have keep going back to the main goal, which is to change the way that Reno Tahoe is viewed. Because I grew up in Orange County. We spent the last 5-6 years in New York City. I understand LA and I understand New York and I understand the viewpoint of Reno outside of the city, and it's just not what it should be. Right. Reno is not Reno 911. It's not
It's not
the lesser Vegas. It's actually an incredible place with some of the most amazing people I've ever met. So to be able to change the view, even if we start regionally, then we start nationally, and then eventually internationally.
But when we start promoting it, the shock factor alone will be significant.
Yeah. So we're going to shock the pants off you.
You know, the people that live here are obviously proud to be here, but I want to see recognition when you say, I'm from Reno.
Right.
And they say, wow, isn't that where so-and-so is from? And mention some artist or some design or something and say, yeah, that's what we're known for.
That's the
I'm telling you, I am so grateful. And as Jazzy Georgia says, we're blessed and grateful. We are blessed and grateful for such an amazing community, for being here at Mari Chuy's in Midtown. And on it's that time again. We're going to take another break. And we want, if you want to watch the show, you can go to phoenixmedia.us. You can also go to abouttowndeb.com and on YouTube. We have the replay. Please join us. Like our Facebook pages. What's your Facebook page before I go?
I think it's the same as our Instagram.
Okay.
So Reno Fine Arts Collective.
Reno Fine Arts Collective. So we're going to take a break. And we come back, we're going to show you some amazing nachos that little mama here was craving.
Yes.
And we're going to talk a little bit about tequila. And you might even see me taking a shot of this amazing...
Don't mess it up.
Fagonero? Yes. And we might even have Amy with Tavern Craft, or we may have Charles Moberly with us. So stay tuned. We'll be right back after this break. It's About Town Deb with City Talk. Stay tuned.
People been saying to your friend, get a different face, and posting on their feed, they're super ugly. The things they say to them online are cruel and they're not true. So tell your friend, I'll stand up for you. Don't worry, I know what to do.
Know someone being bullied online? You can be a witness and make a difference by letting the world know it isn't cool and by letting your friend know you care. Learn more at eyewitnessbullying.org, brought to you by the Ad Council.
Keyboard Cat, Hamilton the Pug, and Toast Meets World. These are some of the internet's most beloved pets. And they all have one thing in common. Their stories started in a shelter. Start your story. Adopt a dog or cat today. Visit theshelterpetproject.org to find a pet near you. Training that pet to play the keyboard, that's optional. Start a story. Adopt a shelter or rescue pet today. Brought to you by Maddie's Fund, the Humane Society of the United States, and the Ad Council.
Allison is perfect. I mean, she'd never tell you that. She's humble and perfect. She likes everyone. She even likes her untidy roommate's weird guinea pig. Allison, wait, are you texting and driving? Allison, no. That's the exact opposite of what I was just saying about you. Why, Allison? Why? Texting and driving makes good people look bad. Visit StopTextStopRex.org, brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration and the Ad Council.
We are live outside the home of Joe and Rosie Goddard, where a pretty big tickle fight broke out just minutes ago. Sources say their father instigated the laughter. Let's go inside for a comment. Apparently, they have no comment. Dads, let this be a reminder that it only takes a moment to make a moment. Call 877-4DAD-411 or visit fatherhood.gov. Brought to you by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services and the Ad Council.
Welcome to Calvin's Barbershop.
You all gotta see this.
I don't even wanna know what you're looking at on that phone.
Well, you should. I was learning about the dangers of high blood pressure and that we need to get ours checked regularly. High blood pressure can increase the risk of heart attack or stroke, but this text program can help keep it at a healthy range. Just text Barbershop to 97779 to sign up.
I'll get right on it as soon as I'm done with this baby panda video.
Text Barbershop to 97779. A message from the American Heart Association and the Ad Council.
Now more than ever, family matters, and Surratt Law Practice has your family in mind. Kimberly Surratt and her team have been helping maintain healthy families through their holistic approach to adoption, surrogacy, child custody, estate planning, and more for over 13 years. Your family law concerns are in caring hands with Surratt Law. Schedule your private consultation with a compassionate Surratt Law Practice team member today by calling 775-636-8200 or visiting lawyersforfamilies.com. Surratt Law, where family matters.
You're listening to Fenix Media. Listen live and explore more great shows at phoenixmedia.us.
Ready to help from her toes to her head. Just give her a shout. Call About Town Deb.
My town, your town, or any town. This is About Town Deb presents City Talk. Now back to the show.
And welcome back to the final segment of City Talk. And I'm About Town Deb, your host. We are at Mari Chuy's, Reno, Nevada, in Midtown. And I'm really excited because Eric Castillo is going to be here. He's like Mari Chuy's guy, but not that kind of guy. He's the main guy. He does. And I love to tease Eric, but Eric does a lot with a lot of our local Midtown and beyond businesses in Reno. So he does photos, does video. And he's incredible. So he's going to represent Mari Chuy. Mari Chuy has an event coming up. There's a tequila tasting going on. We're going to hear about that. But before Eric gets here, Kevin, O'Keefe, thank you. Oh, my gosh. And you know what? He didn't think he had the moves, but he was. And you know what? So I also want to thank you for bringing your class, your style. You're fitting right into our community, and you're bringing goodness and kindness and excitement. So thank you for sharing that with us. And I'm going to be your I'm your wine gal. So yeah. Just so you know.
Don't worry.
Okay. Now Brianna's going to stay because she's a little hungry mama with a little bun in the oven. Don't.
It's delicious.
And we're going to have Eric Castillo here is going to pop in here. Come on, Eric. So Eric is going to he's going to represent all of Midtown because, you know, you love Midtown as well. So can you tell us a little bit about first, what is this amazing nachos?
Oh, yes. The chicken nachos at Chuy's. Great appetizer, or it could just be a full meal. I mean, it's got
these
all
chips
the
are very much a problem.
So the chips are fresh, right?
Yeah, they make the chips in-house. The guac is all in-house. Everything is
how cool
fresh,
is that?
Local.
I love it. We are so excited about that. But there's a lot going on here, Eric. You've got you're crazy busy right now. So tell us about, I think he has a surprise for us. We were talking about the Fogonero. You say it.
El Fogonero.
Did I say it right?
Tequila.
Yep. Tequila. So tell us about, we're going to have a shot. You cannot have a shot.
I've got the nachos.
Eric and I and Jazzy Georgia, she's over there. We're going to try this tequila. Try it live on air here. Pass that to Georgia. No, she has one. Oh. Oh, what? Did you hear that? She goes, just dump it in there. Oh, my gosh. She's getting a double. That is so not fair. Anyway, so, Eric, tell us about what is happening on Tuesdays for the month. This is what's happening. Let's do a cheers real quick.
Cheers.
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 Cheers. Cheers. And here we go. I'm just going to go for it.
Get a little sniff. Mm. And get the full.
I forgot to sniff. I just. Oh my God. Ooh, that was good.
It smells good.
That went down really smooth. Mm-hmm.
That was the reposado. And
wait, say that again.
Reposado.
What does reposado
it's
mean?
It's a style of tequila. So there's añejo, reposado, extra añejo. And basically every week at Chuy's, we'll be sampling a different Fogonero tequila, courtesy of Tavern Craft Distribution in Reno.
Okay.
So Chuy's Tequila Tuesdays, 4 to 6 p.m. Come in on Tuesday at the Sparks location or the Reno location, and you get to sample this amazing El Fogonero tequila.
So when's the next location opening?
So there's going to be a third location opening, the first event.
Tell us where the other two are first. For the people who do not know, if you're not from Reno, tell us exactly the three locations.
Yes. So Midtown is the hub. That's the flagship location, right next to Whispering Vine, across from Shay's, next to Two Chicks. And then in Sparks, we have a location directly next door to the movie theater in Victorian Square. And the third location, which will be opening this summer, officially grand opening, in Ranchera, the village of Ranchera.
So tell us.
Right next door to that.
Oh, then you're good. Oh, so
I'll be there.
So have you, I'm sure you've been to Ranchera and you've browsed around. Were you at one of their, they had another event that Chuy was at. Not that long. Okay, we got food coming.
What else is coming?
Yes. Hold on.
Oh, I got my
Okay, whoa, photos. Photos, look at this, quesadilla.
Oh my gosh,
there
check
it is.
That out,
yes.
Guys. Can you see that? I don't know, it's pretty good.
Chicken
and
quesadilla.
It's, oh, smell it.
You know, just a staple. You know.
So does that go with tequila? Or did, which goes
sure.
best with tequila?
I mean, whatever's your speed. You know, I guess today I'm more of a quesadilla speed. I just wanted the basic, you know, traditional quesadilla.
Mm. Okay, well, let's go
nachos,
back.
Nachos, you get more veggies and stuff, so.
Okay.
Well, there's plenty of guap, so that
there's counts. There's plenty of guap. Yep. So, Brianna, so you said that you live right by there in Ranchera.
Yes, but
so,
I haven't gotten there enough.
Okay.
I haven't.
So how do you feel like that's an amazing new area?
It's totally blossoming. There's so much there.
So how do you feel about that?
It's very cool. And so my neighborhood, I'm right across from Bartley Ranch. So my neighborhood has a tiny bridge that they haven't opened yet,
ooh,
but it leads over to that area. So
nice.
Once they open it, I have a freeway to go.
Cool.
So what's exciting is that not only is Chuy going to, well, we call him Chuy, you know, more Chuy and Maria. We got to tell Maria thank you because Maria is the one who keeps things going around here.
Oh, yeah, she's the
Mama
boss.
Maria, we love her. I just told her we should be just doing all the planning because she's a rock star. But I love the idea that Chuy is going to be there. And you want to name some of the other businesses that are there while we're sharing?
Yeah, definitely. Dorinda's Chocolates will be there.
My sponsor.
Yes, they'll also have a location in Ranchera.
Yeah.
And they'll be set up at the event on the 29th, which will be Al Pastor and Roasted Peppers on the patio. It's actually a giant courtyard, though, and they have games out there like bocce ball.
Oh, I know.
Chess. But we'll also have some live entertainment.
Tell about the horses.
With the Mexican culture, kind of highlighting the whole event. And we'll have the caballos bailandos.
Okay, what is that?
Which is the dancing horses.
I don't know. I call them dancing horses.
I got you.
Okay. They're amazing.
But it's kind of like a muchísimo kind of display of Mexican kind of macho.
Do you speak Spanish?
A little bit.
Muchísimo. What'd you say? Muchísimo.
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 Yeah.
I'm excited for that. Muchísimo.
Yeah, so they actually perform at the rodeo as well.
Yes.
And then we're going to have Ballet Folklorico, which is a traditional Mexican dancing.
Oh, that is cool.
They flail their dresses around, and they're all handmade dresses. They're
maybe I can
dresses.
Flail.
Yeah. We can all flail.
We can all flail.
Okay, now I have to go.
You have to go. I may have. Okay, if you're out there listening, if you have a dress I can flail in, Downtown Deb might do a flail and ride a horse. I don't know.
Cool.
I want to ride a horse. I want to get on the horse.
Yes.
I do, with my flailing.
You might be able to get on
can
the horse.
Can I flail and ride a horse?
Probably.
I want to flail in my horse.
Or live.
Wear a dress and flail on the horse. I have some,
I would pay to see that.
I know. I have to have some kind of Debbie talk in the show. They can't breathe, but that's what I do. So, Eric, so seriously,
yes.
The other person, there's more businesses that we do support. Mm-hmm. We're going to have Dulce Vita Spa.
Yep, they're already out there. They're already going.
They're already going.
And they'll be set up at the event.
And they have my
massages.
Wine. I'm excited.
Yes, they have the wine.
They
We're going to have
wine.
Deb's wine as well.
Yay!
So,
but Eric, tell us your favorite part about, you've been with Chuy for many years.
Yeah,
so tell us.
Years.
So tell us what it's like to watch him grow with all the different locations. What is that like?
I mean, it's a lot of, you know, every day is a struggle in the restaurant business.
Yes, it is.
And Chuy's on the front lines there with his team every day. It's really inspiring to watch him come here, open it every day, close it every day. It motivates me, for one, and I know he has the support of his team. There's no turnover here. You know, people stay for a long time because we have that support and we have that leadership that we need to, you know, keep going every day and keep us, like I said, motivated and inspired. Opening the Sparks location, December 2019, you know, right before the pandemic started.
Wow, yeah.
You know, we were very excited about that, and kind of wind got taken out of the sails, but we kept strong.
They
and
did.
Events are coming back now this summer in Sparks. So we held on, and we're going to crush it this summer, but we're also going to have another location in Ranchera that provides not only a whole new set of obstacles, but a whole different set of fun
feel.
Opportunities.
So tell me about, the feel is a little bit different. It's going to like, wow, kind of snazzy. So a little bit, can
but
you...
still chewy.
No, it's always going to be chewy.
He's going to have his culinary touch on it. You know, he has that restaurant background, 20 years in the casino business, opening all the restaurants in Silver Legacy and beyond. So he'll still have that culinary focus on the food, but we're going to have a real kind of a shift to a tequila kind of bar, and a retail space for tequila, really high-end tequilas that you won't see
tequila
at other locations. So each Chuy's location has something special, right? So that all the regulars of Chuy's can go to the different locations when they want to experience that, you know, little uniqueness of each location and style we want to put on it. So Tequileria y Botanas at Ranchera. Botanas are Mexican bites or appetizers, kind of like tapas. So that's kind of the idea behind the name, and serving more small plates, kind of fine Mexican dining, those high-end top shelf tequilas.
I love that part. Mm-hmm. So Eric, I know we're getting close to the end. So where do you see you? So tell us a little bit about you and your company.
So I have my own company called Elsy Agency. My business partner, Tony Contini, and I do marketing for several businesses around town.
Share them.
And with a focus on restaurants.
Share
so
them.
Chuy's is kind of our flagship one that we've been doing the longest. We also do Noble Pie, which is a more recent count. We've done Hukava for a year now. Hukava is a hookah lounge.
Hookah lounge,
And then we do Brasserie St. James for about a half a year since they reopened. We've been doing Brasserie St. James, the brewery restaurant in Midtown. And
the
then
noodles?
We have a healthcare company, Wellcentric.
Ooh, I like
they
that.
They do ketamine infusions and functional medicines. Dr. Bob, shout out Dr. Bob and Tina.
Hello, Dr. Bob.
And we also do EG.
I love EG, and they're going to be on our show soon.
Yes.
So hang tight. We love that.
Awareness Month.
I know. I'm excited about
that. That's going to be fun.
So I want to say thank you, Eric. Do you have a website?
Yes, elsyagency.com. It's E-L-S-Y agency.com.
Brianna, your website one more time. Thank you.
www.renofineartscollective.com.
So I got to tell you guys, thank you, thank you, thank you. Next week, I'm not going to tell you where we're going to be live, but we've been taking applications for amazing volunteers in our community, and we're going to be announcing the winner. And Kurgalore with Gratis Gives is my co-host. So I love that we are all together in this. So remember, Together We Are One Heart is About Town Deva City Talk. Thank you to my amazing guests. I'll see you next week. And be kind, be good, and know I love you.